age, generation. Basically, the suggestion is that if what you're doing is you're doing to get a job and be employed and get a salary, then you're already ready to fail, and you'll fail miserably. That's what I heard from the speakers. And I tend to think they were right 80%. What a learning experience. Doing a survey means attending seminars and workshops where some of these discussions have been held. If you're on Facebook, for example, na sikia kuna seminar, na watu wanalipa 10,000, 5,000, invest in those to change your life. One seminar, if you're in education, you're an investment. Ukisikia kuna seminar, spend your money, you'll never regret it. In KCM, all over the country, there are workshops, there are seminars for people who want to improve their lives, people want to change their destinies. Whether you're a civil servant, you're a teacher, you're an investor, school up thousands of seminars. And Nehemiah Alifanya survey, he did a survey. In whichever area or whatever you want to get involved with, do not ignore facts. I'm currently reading a book called The Emerging Church. The idea is that church is changing. What church was in 1970s, church is not in 1980s, and church is not in 1990s. For example, when you get into Europe, nobody wants to get into a building with a cross on it and written church. They don't believe in it. All the people who are 80 years plus will enter that thing. But the younger people hate anything called church, anything with a cross on it. They'll avoid it. We used to do hymns. There's a generation that don't do hymns. They do what you call contemporary music. When I grew up, preaching was about how much you can shout at people. And the louder you are, the more anointed you are. How many of you remember those days? And Peter, if you remember, you had to shout loud. And then all preachers had a big handkerchief that looked like a towel. And you must sweat. In fact, you are young men who had several handkerchiefs. He handkerchief is a chopper. Wana chukua, wanaweka kwa maji, na kawa hindi. Wakapa wana kumbuka hiyo. And again, you also have to have a lot of saliva as you preach. By the time unamaliza, hii microphone yo kutengeja saliva. And kama mto, ipaku na siku, washirika hapa wanataka ukapa mbele. Because the anointing of saliva will be all over. And those are the real men of God. Before that, the preachers had to cry. Wanaubiri mpaka wanalia. If you don't know how to cry, sauti. So, and then things change, and there's a generation saying, we just want to understand. But you see, for us who preach those days, my problem is, can God really move without shouting? But is it possible? I don't think so. You can't say, come out in Jesus' name. Job, do demons do that? You demon come out in Jesus' name. Do they? You must say, come out! That's what they understand. But the only demons are dead. But then you see, I'm just telling you that I'm absorbing information that there's a generation that just want to understand. I was preaching in a high school and I thought high school students should really appreciate the knowledge. So God told me to teach, and that took 1.5 hours explaining the gospel without sweat. And when we asked those who wanted to be saved, we could not tell them to come forward because there was no space for them to stand. They had an attitude. So, as a minister, I must do a survey. Nehemiah, you find a survey. Survey the job market. Survey your career. Talk to other people. Read what you can read. And understand what's going on. We are getting into a system in the church where God is calling on Christians to be taught and anchored on the word, and to be under a revelation, prophetic and apostolic, and teaching. The prophetic, the apostolic, and the teaching grace is increasing every day. And God's people just want to go deeper. The excitement is over. Today, if the only thing you can do is to make people fall down when you are preaching, you might have gone to mini mwenda kwa mkutano na ukiona mhubiri anaangusha watu, unaona Wakristo wanahepa hiyo laini kwa sababu ya gharama ya omo anaomba. Lakini zamani when I grew up, Pastor Peter, unakumbuka kama kuna laini tatu, kwa laini moja wale wanaanguka na hiyo ngine tu mtu anaanguka. Sasa kila mtu anaenda huko kuanguka. Lakini siku hizi jini ni watu wamebackslide. Kama unaangusha watu wanakuhepa. Even the craze of anointing oil is dying down. Christians are making sober, are making mature. So the first thing Nehemiah did was to pray. The second thing we learned was prayer. He took a lot of time in prayer. Prayer. And he had seasons and sessions of praying and fasting. He had his Wednesday night prayer, Friday night kesha. Lakini kuna aina ya mambo mengine Nehemiah alifanya without a touch on, and that is the walking prayer. Ukisoma Nehemiah, it was so good that this type of prayer you make without closing your eyes. And unaongea na mtu, lakini deep down in your heart, unaomba. He says in chapter 2, then the king asked me, Nehemiah, what do you want? He was standing in front of the king. Kwanza akasema, unataka nini Nehemiah? Alafu anasema, hapo hapo nikaomba. Nikauliza Mungu. Na Mungu kaniambia, alafu I told the king, do this to me. So the king said, Nehemiah, so what do you want? I don't think he left God. He said, let me talk to God first. No. Kuna ile maombi unafanya haraka in 1 minute. You can do it as you drive. You're walking on your bed. Suddenly an issue comes to your heart. And in 1 minute, you raise it to God. You know, we've been taught that unless you kneel down, unless you raise your hands, you assume maombi. God has not answered. God answers not only the prayer that you utter, but the prayer that Nehemiah made before the king, he didn't speak a word. It was a prayer from the heart directly to God. And that's something you can cultivate, walking prayer. Walking prayer. The prayer of the heart. And that's where Paul says, pray without ceasing. Unaweza kuwa unaongea na mtu, unaona hasira yake inapanda. You can also raise your voice, but in that moment, you can quickly utter a prayer to God, and the whole problem will be solved, and the argument comes to stop. The walking prayer. But Nehemiah was a man of prayer. Then the third thing is this prayer of favor, which I want us to really think about, that God may, he prayed that God may give him favor. Now, 7 times in Nehemiah, the word favor stroke grace appears. Favor stroke grace. He asked the Lord for favor, he asked God for grace. And I'm thinking this is something we could pray for. Favor is God's favor or God's grace upon our lives. And this favor is manifested in Jacob. God tells him, you have had favor with God, therefore you will have favor with men. And the first place is to have God's favor in your life. And if you have God's favor, man's favor is full. You prevail with God, then you prevail with man. The angel told Mary, oh Mary, you are greatly favored above all women. One of the things I trust God for in my ministry is that God may give me grace. The grace to lead, the grace to teach, the grace to understand, the grace to minister. God's favor. When that happens, your ministry, your life, your business, your job will enjoy you because you're doing it as a result of the grace of God. I want to pray that you may seek God, you may ask God to favor you. I've heard somebody saying that what will take you 10 years to do, favor will do in 1 month. And it's dangerous to ask God for favor because it will bring you in conflict, because jealousy and envy will come. I was asked to preach somewhere, tukawa wawili kama tano hivi, tatu ni wazungu na wawili ni black people like you, not me. And nikaongea na mwenye hiyo mkutano, nikamwambia tafadhali, kama umeleta wazungu hapa, wacha hawa wazungu wawili, sisi tutafanya intercession. Wakati wa lunch we distribute lunch, usituweke na wazungu ati tunahubiri pamoja. Tulikuwa lazima ni hiyo all of God. I said we are all servants of God, lakini kuna watu wako na neema ingine, wengine hawana. Hii unaweza kuwa na neema lakini hauna neema. Sasa huyu my brother, mimi nitahubiri hata next year, wacha hawa wazungu waendelee na kuhubiri. Huyu ndio alikataa. So akasema, sasa tungeleza ruto mbili saa tatu, alafu utakuwa na break saa nne, wataenda kwa groups, utakuwa na kikundi, akadistribute watu. Nikakataa, nikamwambia wacha huyu mzungu achape ingine. Huyu mzungu bado akaanza. Unajua, when I'm talking to you, you need to understand. Because I've had 34 years experience. So alikataa. So I said, now wacha huyu mzungu achape ingine. Akasema ndio wewe. So we had about 1,500 people attending. So I took that session, and as I was preaching, the grace of God, unfortunately, was there. So I had to enter for groups. 3/4 waliingia kwa tenti yangu. Wanataka niendelee. Mzungu akawacha, bila watu, karibu watu kumi na kitu wameenda kwa hema ya mzungu. Mi nikasikia mzungu anauliza huyu jamaa, hii mkutano ilikuwa yangu ama yule mhubiri? Mulinitoa Amerika kuja hapa kuongea na watu 15, nani ametoa pesa? Sasa nikamuuliza, nilikwambia unaona shida, huyu mzungu ndiye mwenye pesa. Na kuna tofauti kati ya pesa na neema. Mzungu akakataa kuhubiria hao watu. So nikaona nakuja kwa tenti yake, akakaa. When he sat, I said a few things, then I said the man of God is here, I want to give him the next minute aangushe kitu hapa, because nilikuwa nataka kusaidia huyu mzungu. Sisi wenye pesa wame na watu. So he talked. and we became very good friends. So don't underrate the grace of God. God's grace will open resources, amazing resources. God's grace will give you an opening in the hearts of people. God's grace will bring business your way. God's grace can favor. Nehemiah prayed for favor, and seven times he says, the grace of God, or the favor of God, was upon me. And I told the people of the favor of God. I wish that you may have so much favor until you feel it. Until when you walk, you say, God's favor. I tell you, my friend, 10 years of hard work is equal to one day of favor before God. Unakumbuka dada anaitwa Ruth. Favor changes her life in one day. In one day she was a beggar. The same day she was a queen. In just one day. Esther, favor. God's favor can change your life in just one day. The construction we are doing at Open Christian Academy is favor. We don't qualify. Nobody has ever asked us even for a registration document or the statement of accounts. They don't even know whether we are registered or not. They just want to give us money and money and money. Because of favor. Because of grace. This year we have stopped 4 projects. But the guy is asking me that apart from Open Christian Academy, which other project do I have that I can invest in? Sijauliza. Yeye ndiye anauliza. So brethren, if you come for a prayer meeting, why not just pray that God give me favor, man? Kuna ndugu anaitwa Reverend Kosi. Alituhubiria ukiwa sekondia 1988. Na alikuwa kiwete. Anaweka viatu hapa. Not on the shoes, alafu anatembea kama chura. Na ni ndugu anachapa injili sana. Msichana wake anaimba. Anaitwa nani? Emi. And when he came, akakwambia that bibi yake ni graduate. He said he married a graduate with normal legs. Akatwambia ni favor. Huyo dada hakuona kiwete. Aligundua huyu ndugu ni kiwete after the honeymoon. So favor can even make you blind. Normally, he should not have married, but favor. And he was a Form 6 dropout, married a graduate. So, don't say you are not learning. I want to learn. So instead of just working hard, si wape tu Mungu akupe favor. Huyo sasa ni bibi ama ni sponsor? Even if God gives you a sponsor, ni mbaya. Huyo ni bibi ama ni sponsor? Yaani ni baada ya honeymoon, uko na kifunguo ya gari na ya nyumba. Hivyo tu. I did a wedding for a young man, and on the wedding day they were given a present of a Toyota Harrier and an apartment worth 8 million shillings, fully furnished, with everything, washing machine, gas cooker. Some of you would have had a need. I'm talking to you singles. when you just get a husband and a wife, then you start traveling. Now look. Hey, this guy, you know, imagine. Honeymoon and work for where guys are the higher. Now apartment, fully furnished. Labu na bea kutoka honeymoon, utaonyesha mahali hizo vitu ziko. Na kuja gari ndio hiyo, na logo, na nyumba ndio hiyo. Yako. So, wenye wamesikia ujumbe ya leo, tafadhali, kama haujaolewa na haujaoa, consider favor. Favor can change your life. Forever. And whoever findeth a wife has favor with God. Now, not whoever gets. Wives are things you find. You don't get. If you get, who are you? You find. And if you're a man of favor, look for a woman. When you have a favor. If you find another struggler, and you're not a struggler, and both of you are hustling, sasa hiyo ndio kombo kweli. Two hustlers. You imagine?